And welcome to our community. Susie Thomas with you this morning. We are welcoming Sarah Heckert and Aaron Kitzmiller from Gigi's Playhouse. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
First of all, I think Gigi's Playhouse is probably new to many of us. Can you tell us what it is?
Sure. I'd love to give a little background. Gigi's Playhouse is a Down Syndrome Achievement Center. There are 37 of them actually nationally now, or internationally, because there's one in Mexico as well. There's only one other one in Ohio, up in the Cleveland area. So we're very excited that we're working on the second Gigi's in Ohio, Gigi's Playhouse. And as a Down Syndrome Achievement Center, what does that mean? Well, really what we're trying to do and what Gigi's does do is set up a network of people, individuals who come together and will help families, individuals with Down syndrome, their siblings, anyone in their community as they go before they're even born and all the way through their lifespan. So as a toddler, as a school age, as a graduate of school and past that, the goal is to help all these individuals and their families really find their truest potential. And what that is continuing to work hard and continuing to understand and you know, debunk myths about Down syndrome, about individuals with Down syndrome, and really find that place where people can, that place of acceptance and this place of inclusion. There's so much great things going on right now with inclusion and acceptance in the world, and we're continuing to move to that. And there's a lot of great people out there, a lot of great things they can do. And Gigi's Playhouse is a way to connect all that together. And that's what we're doing, really bringing it all together, one place, one location, which we will have soon, but also more than that, a network of people and individuals.
And so once it's built and everybody has this place to meet and go, you are not just serving the children with Downs, you are also serving their siblings and their parents, something for everyone. You both, we should say you're interested in this, you both are parents of children with Down syndrome?
Yes, ma'am.
And Sarah, let me start with you. I love this story. Yeah. You adopted your child.
Ava is 2 years old, and she, yes, indeed, is adopted here domestically from the U.S.
All right. You know, you're blowing one myth right there out of the water, because we're told that children with Downs that are harder to place. Were you specifically looking for a child with Down syndrome to bring into your family?
We were. My aunt had Down syndrome. She has since passed away. But so I have grown up with disabilities in my family and, you know, sort of don't know any differently. Yeah, my husband and I were pursuing. He has worked in the disabilities field his entire career, as have I. And so when we kind of made this, you know, commitment to adopt, we just knew that this was the way God was going to have us go in pursuing a child with Down syndrome. And to debunk a myth, there's a waiting list. There's not just they're difficult to place, but there is an actual registry. You have to be chosen by birth parents. You just don't get plucked off a list. And there were several times that we were not chosen, that there was better fits for families other places. And but Ava's a pretty good fit in our puzzle. So so we're happy to have her.
So Ava is how old again?
She's 2 years old.
And yep. Is she your only child, or has she got siblings?
She has two siblings. She has a 12-year-old sister and a 10-year-old brother.
So this had to be a family decision. Did you sit down with the children as well, your children that were already in the home, and say, we're thinking of doing this. Well, we would be doing this as a family. How did they receive that? Obviously pretty well. How did you navigate it?
It was a long process. We had to, you know, get our house ready and do the home study. And so every piece of that they were present for. You know, we have to get us new smoke detectors, and we have to get new fire extinguishers, and, you know, just basic things. And we talked about it for years. I mean, it was something we... and, you know, we expose our kids to people with disabilities. Our church, actually, First Christian here in Canton, has a huge disability ministry. And I was actually employed there for quite some time in their disability ministry. So, again, it's just not something that's foreign to our kids or our family at all. So it wasn't a surprise to them that this is the path that we would be pursuing. So they were excited, and, you know, I think the girl wanted a girl and the boy wanted a boy, of course. But
so that was the bigger issue.
Yeah.
And has the boy come around? He's okay with his little baby sister?
He's ready for another boy, so we'll That's a whole nother broadcast. So, yeah.
Another conversation for another day. Aaron, how about your story?
My story. My son, Max, he is 8 years old, going on 9. We did not get diagnosed beforehand, so it was a surprise. And honestly, it was a very scary surprise. Mm-hmm. Max could not be more loved in our family, but we were very nervous. And Max actually since then has been diagnosed with autism as well. So he has Down syndrome and autism. But he is... he's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And he only really gets, there's the best thing, and what Gigi's I think will help bring to a lot of people is there's only certain people that get to know my son and that want to get to know him. And I'm not blaming anyone for that. I understand. But I have a few friends that are really dedicated to being in his life. And I think Gigi's will bring that opportunity to more people as they see that in an environment that they're comfortable with. So he has his good days and bad days just like any other child. And that's really what it's about. You know, as a dad, I think sometimes too, there's so much onus on moms and how important they are in the lives of their children. And sometimes as a dad, we can take a back seat, but Max has become, you know, the center of my life as my other children and you know, needs me more than ever. And make sure that that's for the rest of his life, I'm a prominent role in that. I appreciate that opportunity, honestly. I think a lot of parents will say this, and, you know, what Sarah did is beyond admirable. And if your child is born into a situation where they have special needs, you're not a special parent. You know, you are not a superhero. You're just like anybody else, and you just step up and do what you need to do. You know, and I think a lot of people want to give us more credit than we should have, that we were chosen for a reason. I don't necessarily believe that. I just believe that we do what we have to do for our kids no matter what, and that's what any parent would do as far as my understanding of it. So.
Well, both of these kids landed in great homes.
Well, we appreciate that.
With awesome parents, well, no matter what you say. So. but there's got to be a progression of getting that diagnosis. There you are, the excitement of new birth, and everybody has our preconceived ideas of what that's going to look like. And when it ends up looking a little bit differently, how did you get from there to where you are now, which is obviously in a very good place?
Right. That's a good question. I think with Down syndrome, you know, there's tells, I guess, that are different maybe than some other special needs when children are born. So the story is, and when Max was born, and there are some unfortunate stories, and there's no one to blame. But again, what we want to do is help. Educate mm-hmm. and inspire, and let's take it that next step. And, you know, when Max was born, I actually was not in the hospital when Max's mom was told by the doctor at the time that he may have Down syndrome. In fact, the physician or the doctor at the time asked everyone to leave the room and just talk to her by herself. I was at home taking care of dogs, you know, all that kind mm-hmm. of fun stuff. Her mom and her grandma were asked to leave the room. And it was a one-on-one conversation of just, you know, we think he might have Down syndrome. And that was it. And it was really to do it at a time when, first of all, the father wasn't there. And mm-hmm. to request that everyone else leave and give this kind of surprising information that you're not necessarily prepared for at that time.
Right.
It was, again, one of the reasons we're doing what we're doing.
Yes.
And one of the reasons that, you know, before diagnosis is so important as well, and how to get started. And, you know, from there, you do what you can as a parent, and you find out as much information as you can. And, you know, I think Sarah, what she started doing with the pre-diagnosis packets is amazing, and it helps in so many ways. And I think she should tell a little bit more information about that.
Let's talk about that. Let's park there a little bit, because evidently it sounds to me like there's not that much for parents once you get that diagnosis. What do hospitals do at this point when you're diagnosed?
Sure. So obviously, again, my daughter I was not there when she was born. You know, she's adopted. But
sure.
Aaron and I represent a launch team of about 12 people, and the majority of our folks do indeed have children with Down syndrome, of course. And I've heard all of their stories, and having worked in the disabilities field, I've heard hundreds of stories. But parents are typically, if it's an at-birth diagnosis, you know, maybe there's a nurse that happens to know somebody, a neighbor with Down syndrome, and she'll hand you a sticky note that says, call my friend Rachel. She has a son, Timmy.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you can talk to her.
Mm-hmm. So there's nothing formal, nothing.
You might get a book. You might get the Down syndrome mm-hmm. child, babies with Down syndrome book. You might get a brochure that's probably a little faded, a little dated. But yeah, your point is definitely stands. There's nothing formal. So we have all taken this very seriously, and one of our team members shares the story well of she was handed a sticky note with an email address of somebody that I don't even know if they ever got back to her, actually, even after she did reach out. But she went home and started scavenging the internet, mm-hmm. and just found Gigi's Playhouse, 2.5 years ago, and said, I just want to see a child that's older than mine, and I want to see that they're okay.
Mm-hmm.
And she wanted a physical place to go to do that, but there wasn't any. There's the internet.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what we want Gigi's Playhouse to be, is that physical location of come and see at both age 2, at age 8, at age 18,
yes.
at age 28, 48, 68, we're doing okay.
Yes.
So we've created these new diagnosis baskets.
Tell me about what's in the basket. Yeah. What do these do?
So there's actually about $150 worth of goods, if you will, in the basket. There are books. There's books for siblings, books for young siblings, books for older siblings. There's, of course, Gigi's swag. We've got some bracelets in there, a little T-shirt, a onesie. There's books about Down syndrome adoption. There's books about just other people's memoirs of their birth diagnosis. There's actually a 4-DVD set of baby sign language, which a lot of our kids start out communicating mm-hmm. using uh-huh. some basic signs. So that's the gist of it. But it's colorful. It's fun. There's some toys, some little therapeutic toys, some baby toys.
Already for an infant? Or as as they begin to grow a little
bit.
Yeah,
for an infant.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Just some very stimulating therapeutic toys that were recommended to a lot of us. So it's fun. It's colorful. It's in a cute tote that you can keep and use. We've made them, attractive, if you will, to try to just lower that stigma of this is a burden. This is not a burden. This is
a person.
A person.
A little person, a little bundle of potential.
Yeah, and I think it's important that it's not a burden. It's as a parent, you have dreams for your children, and sometimes you have to adjust those dreams one way or another. And that doesn't mean anything. But that happens for every child.
I was just going to interrupt you there and say, when does that not happen?
You're absolutely right. And I think it just that's what I went through as a dad sometimes, and it hasn't hurt me to do that. It's just adjusting what you're seeing and these gains and these this day something else happened, and it's like, wow, that's just as exciting as it would have been no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're seeing it from a different way. But I think the important thing that about the baskets, they're completely free. I mean, these are donated baskets. Everything that we do through Gigi's, the biggest thing about Gigi's that, forgive me for not mentioning this, is that this is all volunteer and it's all free. Like, this is not bill your insurance. This is not, you don't have insurance, I'm sorry, it's going to be this much. This is completely, absolutely 100% free. And that's the goal of this, is to be in a community, provide for community members free of charge. And that's very unique. And we're excited to be in an opportunity where we're looking at that and saying, this is what we can do and what we're going to do and how we're going to help people.
And one of the greatest things I hear you talking about here is it connects you with other families who are walking this path as well. How important that is for any young parents. I think any young parents that feel a little bit nervous about parenthood, period. And then you do have this additional icing on the top. So to be able to connect with other parents really going through these same developmental stages, how helpful is that?
It's huge. It's huge. You can't put words to it, really. I mean, again, when you're able to look at a child that's a little further down the road, and that Aaron can say to me, yeah, we did that too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, we went through that phase too. Oh, yep, I remember that. And, just kind of be able to and laugh with you along the bumps and the bruises for sometimes. but just say, we're here. We're together. We got this. We're going to get through this.
Awesome. We're speaking with Sarah Heckert and Aaron Kitzmiller talking about Gigi's Playhouse. We'll be back after these words. You're listening to Our Community.